If you are looking to build a gaming PC anywhere in the world and you want some really good price performance, then this PC right here, sitting on a box, may be the best option for you. So today we're going to show you how you can build this thing and see what FPS it can get in Cyberpunk 2077 and also Fortnite. I got some good news and bad news, and that is with this build right here, I actually ordered an ATX case, but the seller pretty much duped me in that they gave me the tracking number for the case and they sent it to someone else. So you do have to be aware of this, I guess, potential scam going on. And so therefore, today's video, we're going to be, again, building this all the AliExpress gaming PC on a box. Now, one thing about the graphics cards, they have gone up in price pretty much all over the world. Graphics cards, for some reason, especially under that $300 price point, they're all in relatively high demand. However, we can see that the 4GB versions of the RX 580, for example, and RX 570 aren't too bad in terms of price point. And that's because the cryptocurrency Ethereum miners don't want this card. So in today's build, we're gonna go with a colorful A320 motherboard. Now I've tested this out, and it actually represents decent value, especially for being shipped worldwide. Then we're gonna go with a 480GB SSD from KingFast. For memory, we've got 16GB of Glowway, and then for the CPU, we're using none other than the Ryzen 5 2600. Also, some other important things is the CPU cooler is the Dark Flash. This thing's gonna bring a bit of bling, as well as give a downdraft towards the motherboard to hopefully keep the VRM a little bit cooler, since we are using the 6-core 12 thread on an A320. Then the last piece of the puzzle is the Warrior AK600 from Igo. This is a 600 watt power supply with a bit of RGB bling on it. And then we're gonna see if this thing can play Cyberpunk 2077 on a budget. Let's do this. And our build on the power supply box is now finished. And you may notice there's two unique things about this build this time around. That is, we're using a power connector switch and reset switch and LEDs off an old build that we pulled apart. And we're also utilizing the front panel USB. And we've also got front panel HD audio. So this build is already swaggered up and it is looking mint. It's actually pretty quiet too. And it's got a bit of bling to go with it. So all those people saying you need a case, we're gonna find out if you really do need a case when we do some benchmarks on this thing very soon. But what we're doing right now is setting up Windows 10 and just installing that with our USB installer. And that's installing on the SSD here, which is 480GB. Plenty enough for installing Cyberpunk and Fortnite and even modern warfare, if you wanna go with that route, because this PC should be able to play it. Though, there's another thing too, and that is we've gotta tune this thing up before we start playing games, especially the memory here, where we wanna get the XMP profiles locked in, and we also wanna make sure that the temperatures of the GPU and the CPU are absolutely fine, and there's nothing crashing before we get into the games. And here we are now, just stress testing the CPU out on this motherboard, making sure nothing's wrong. And we've also thrown in the system memory, which is our DDR4, which we've clocked to 3200 megahertz via the colorful BIOS's auto profile, which is working extremely well on this Ryzen 5 2600. Now, temperatures are good, noise is pretty good. I'm really up close to it. And this is also in 27 degrees. Ambient temperatures are kind of, just want to put this, have this spinning on here. There we go. 27 degrees. And the GPU is running at a reasonably cool 67 degrees in this 27 degree ambient environment. And another thing is too, is I'm guessing that the AliExpress sellers of these graphics cards do change the thermal paste, because I'm noticing if the thermal paste hasn't been changed on these graphics cards,
then the temperatures will get a little bit hotter than usual. So, not bad at all. It's time for Cyberpunk. And the PC aside, we've got the numbers right here with Cyberpunk 2077. And I'm guessing it's the bad news in that it's 40 FPS, but it's playable and the picture looks pretty decent. Now this was at low settings at 1080p and we had to put the Fidelity FX setting to 80. Now I found that this was, for me personally, a balance between at least enjoying this game. Anything lower than 40 FPS and I'd seriously start to struggle, especially on a fast action-paced game like this, where most of the time it's first person, then when you're driving you can change it to third person, but you're moving really fast regardless. So you do want, in my opinion, try to get around 60 FPS. So the problem is, when we did drop it to 60 FPS, we started getting a undesirable picture in my opinion. So the 40 FPS is doable on this setup, but I think if you're going for more FPS, you're going to lose a lot of picture quality, where we then dropped it down to the lowest settings possible, 720p at 50% render scale, and it still just gave out around 60 FPS. So it seems like sometimes there's some kind of cap in this game that's making the GPU, the thing is the GPU is at 100%, even when we're doing this, so there's some kind of cap in this game that's limiting it at around 60 FPS, depending on your GPU. Now I'm guessing the RX 580, for example, RX 570, and say for instance, GTX 1060s and GPUs like these, they are going to be very popular. So a lot of people are gonna be scratching their head going, okay, I can just play Cyberpunk. So I guess there's that news in that some of the good news is that you can still play Cyberpunk 2077, it's just not gonna be the best experience. But we got up here next up, Fortnite. And so Fortnite was a really good experience on one particular set of settings. And that was when we turned it onto the competitive settings, or at least the low with 100% render scale. We're getting around 200 FPS, very good experience on this PC, and that was on DX12. Now there was a performance mode alpha, and that was just not working properly at all. And there was also DX11, and they just were giving out more stuttering than I would personally prefer, especially in a game like Fortnite, which is very competitive. So this PC does really well on Fortnite at competitive settings and DX12. So I was really happy with that. So games aside, this thing actually represents decent value for money coming out of 2020, where the prices of graphics cards have gone up. And now one thing we did do with this build is it did come in at $475 shipped worldwide, but that's with an RX 570. So I found the prices of RX 580s since when I bought this GPU on AliExpress till now, they have gone up quite substantially. The RX 570 is still a pretty good buy at $130. And for some reason, used GPUs have just gone up in price, their availability's gone down. And the reason for that is I just don't think there's any new cards coming out from Nvidia or AMD on this price point of $200 and under that's bringing that competition. There's still selling RX 580s brand new on the shelf, for example, and that's passing even years later. So I'd like to see both these companies make one of these new cards that could sort of re-inject life into the GPU market, where the rest of the build, the RAM, the 16 gigabytes of RAM, the cooler, the Ryzen 5 2600, the motherboard, and also the 480 gigabyte SSD and the power supply, they all represent really good value for their prices, especially considering that is shipped globally. So there was nothing really to critique here. The noise levels, the temperatures, even the efficiency of this power supply all checked out, where it was consuming about 250 watts in both Cyberpunk and Fortnite. So it was doing a good job of not using up a whole lot of power. And usually an easy way to tell if a power supply is terrible is you can test between two different power supplies the same scenario, and one will be using a lot more power than the other, and that power supply is not as efficient, and that's generally because they've used cheaper components in it. Though a few more things we did do to get this build running smoothly was that we did use the colorful motherboard's built-in memory profiles, which do work a treat. In this case, they brought that 2666 megahertz memory up to 3200 megahertz on the Ryzen 5 2600. Another thing we did do is we did add in a power switch, which they're about $1, and we did add in some USB ports, which we pulled from a used build. If you don't have these components, I'll put all the links for all the stuff in the description below, and I'll also put a Windows 10 Pro Key license in there too, where we had to activate this motherboard with Windows 10 Pro on a retail key. And so I'll put all those links for the description below for you guys. And with that said, it will come in under $500. And considering the current climate of this price point and what you're getting, this is actually not too bad of a deal. And one thing I will say is if you want to get a case, do be very careful on a budget. There's a lot of bad cases out there. The open air test bed here, it was doing the job under 70 degrees on both CPU and GPU in games pretty much all the time. And I was really liking what came out of the build. And the good thing with AliExpress is I found that you do get some kind of warranty in that, in the case of that case that I didn't receive, I put in a dispute and I got my money back. So AliExpress does take care of the buyer in that respect. So if you get something, test it out straight away. If it doesn't work, then you will get a warranty. Unlike the used market at the moment where I am locally, I've been hearing all sorts of stories and I've actually experienced some of these stories myself, buying some used parts recently and getting proverbially hosed. And it hasn't been fun. That's when you buy a used part and it just doesn't work. The person said it worked and it's pretty much, you've lost your money. Anyhow guys, with that build out of the way, hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, then be sure to hit that like button for us. Also let us know in the comments section below if you would change anything on this build, and if so, what would it be? Love reading those thoughts and opinions. As always, just like this question of the day here, which comes from Adan1979, and they ask, have you tried the so-called fixed config files on Reddit for Cyberpunk to work better on PC? And I actually haven't. I haven't checked them out. Scratch that. We actually did some testing on the 30 series, and we found that there was no difference with the memory pool config changes that is going around on Reddit. Now, it might work for some people, but it wasn't working for here, for us at a studio here, where it has to do with, I think, a 3 gig VRAM limit in place, which came from the console config file and made its way onto PC. Then there was also a 1.5 gigabyte system RAM issue as well. Apparently these config files came into PC and they're causing performance dips. What we noticed though with the RX 580 in this case was it was being utilized at 100%. And we saw that with the GPU utilization figures on our rig that we used in the testing on the AliExpress build in today's video. But as for the RTX 3090, we manually set that in the config to use all 24 gigs, but it just ignored it. And it was still using 7 gigabytes at super ultra wide resolution. And then for the system memory, we set that to 64 gigabytes and it was only using 12 gigabytes. So it seems like the game is just ignoring this config file anyhow. And with that, we didn't notice any difference in FPS before and after, though people are reporting it's making a difference for them. So I'll put the link in the description below for that config change. And of course, if you're going to do this, do make a backup of your config file. So if you come into problems, it's gonna be easy to get back to what you were playing on before. Back to you, Past Brian. And that's the unfortunate news. There's gonna be no config files that really can get around it. And if they do get around it, they're probably gonna have a lot of bugs, unfortunately. So hope that answers that question. And if you guys have stayed this far and you're enjoying that content, then be sure to hit that sub button, ring that bell. And I'll catch you in another tech video very soon. Peace out for now. Bye.